Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are fit and fine. Children, as you all know, this is your general knowledge video class. And today we are going to learn and see Indian monuments, which are famous for its quality, its architecture. So children, let's start our class. This is your general knowledge class and today is 16th August 2021. This is your general knowledge class. Class 1. Class 1. Okay. And the chapter is Around India. Around India. Now children, here you can see in this chapter there are so many images of Indian monuments. Suppose Taj Mahal, India Gate, Red Fort, Qutub Minar and Char Minar. So children, first of all we should know who built these buildings, these monuments, and after that we have to see the history first. And after that, we will discuss which option is correct. So children, let's visit these monuments by this video. I would like to give you few images of this, real images of these monuments. First, we will discuss about these monument. Then we will complete the exercise. So children, let's Around India. Here you can see the first image of Lotus Temple. It's a beautiful temple and it is in the shape of lotus. It is situated in Delhi, our capital of India. Children, this is in the shape of lotus, just like lotus, because our national flower is lotus. So Lotus Temple is located in Delhi, India. It is a Baha house of worship and was dedicated in December 1986. Notable for its flower-like shape, it has become a prominent attraction in the city. Like all houses of worship, the lotus is open to all regardless of religion or any other qualification. According to the Shoghi Effendi, a Baha's temple is a silent teacher of the Baha'i faith. The building is composed of 27 free standing marble clad petals arranged in cluster of three to form 9 sides. With 9 doors open into the central hall with the height of the slightly over 34 meters and a capacity of 2,500 people can sit inside. The Lotus Temple has won numerous architectural awards and has been featured in many newspaper and magazine articles. A 2001 CNN report referred to it as the most visited building in India. So the temple was dedicated 23 to 27 December 1986 with a gathering of 8,000 Baha'is from 107 countries, including some 4,000 Baha'is is from the 22 provinces in India. On January 1st is the temple was open to the public and more than 10,000 people visited that first day. By late 2001, it had attracted more than 70 million visitors. According to the Manpreet Brar, a CNN reporter, the permanent delegation of India to UNESCO stated that Lotus Temple has received over 100 million visitors by April 2014. So this is, children, this is the latest you can say observation. And the you can say this is the Baha'i temple. So the Baha'i faith teaches that a Baha house of worship should be a space of the people of all religion of gather, reflect and worship. Anyone may can enter the lotus temple irrespective of the religious background, sects or distinctions, and is the case with all the Baha'i house of worship. The sacred writings of not only the Baha'i faith but also other religion can be read or chanted regardless of language. On the other hand, reading non-scriptural texts is forbidden, as are delivering sermons or lecture or fundraising. Musical renditions of reading and prayers can be sung by choirs, but no musical instrument can be played inside. There is no set pattern for worship service, and ritualistic ceremonies are permitted. Now children, as jaisa ki aapko dikhai de raha hai, this temple is in the shape of lotus. Lotus kamal ke nishan ki tarah ye sundar sa temple hai, aur ye ek Baha'i temple hai. Ab bachcho hum log chalte hain iske structure ke bare mein baat karte hain. All Baha'i houses of worship including the lotus temple share certain architectural elements, some of which are specified by the Baha'i scripture. Abdul Baha, the son of the founder of the religion, stipulated that an essential architectural character of the house of worship is a nine-sided circular shape. While all current Baha'i houses of worship have a dome, this is not regarded as in the essential part of their architecture. Baha'i scripture also states that no pictures, status of images be displayed within the house of worship, and no pulpits or altars be incorporated as an architectural features. Inspired by the lotus flower, the design for the house of worship in New Delhi is composed of 27 feet standing marble clad petals arranged in the cluster of 3 to 9 side. The 9 doors of the lotus temple, as you have already tell this, and this is the distinction of this Baha'i temple. The temple has received a wide range of attention in professional architectural, fine art, religious, governmental and the venues. So many awards this temple has got. That is really, really amazing for us to learn about this beautiful temple. And it is situated in New Delhi, as you all know, children. And you can see this temple from far away, because at the height of the Delhi, you can see this beautiful temple. And if we will say that this beautiful temple is well structured and well architecture is there, so ये गलत नहीं होगा कि ये बहुत ही सुंदर तरीके से बना हुआ है. रात में जब इसमें लाइट्स ऑन हो जाती हैं तो ये बहुत सुंदर सी एक इमेज देता है. हेयर यू कैन सी द लाइट्स आर ऑन एंड दिस पिक्चर, दिस इमेज इज शोइंग यू दैट हाउ ब्यूटिफुल इट इज़ मेड. So children, this is called Lotus Temple, beautiful temple that you can see in this image. Now children, Gateway of India. This is the pride of India, and not be confused with the India Gate, because India Gate is totally different. It is situated in New Delhi, but in Gateway of India, it is situated in Mumbai, Maharashtra. So the World War I Memorial in New Delhi, that is India Gate. Now the Gateway of India is an arch monument built in the early 20th century in the city of Mumbai. It was erected to commemorate the landing in December 1911 at Wellington Pier, Mumbai, of the King Emperor George V and the Queen Empress Mary. The first British monarch to visit India. At the end of the royal visit, the gateway was not yet built and a cardboard structure greeted the monarch. The foundation stone was laid in March 1913 mein iska foundation stone rakha gaya and monument built in the Indo-Saracenic style. The incorporating element of the 16th century Gujarati architecture, the final design of the monument by architect George Wittet ne isko banaya aur bahut hi sundar banaya and was sanctioned only in 1914 and construction was completed in 1924. So children, this is well structured, well designed gateway. So the structure is this triumphal arch made by basalt, which is 26 meter 85 feet, and it is an effort from the architect George Wittet ka ye effort hai jisse ki itna sundar structure taiyar hua. The foundation, as you have seen, after its construction, the gateway was used as a symbolic ceremonial entrance to the British India for important colonial personnel. It has been called a symbol of the conquest, colonization, commemorating British colonial legacy. The gateway is also the monument from where the last British troops left India in 1948. Yani bana ye monarch ke aane ke liye, aur jab India ka last British troop left kiya, India ko choda in 1948 following Indian independence, it is located on the waterfront at the angle opposite to the Taj Mahal Palace and Tower Hotel and overlooks the Arabian Sea. Today the monument is the synonymous with the city of Mumbai and is amongst its prime tourist attraction. The gateway is also a gathering spot for the local street vendors and photographers soliciting services. It holds significance for the local Jewish community and it has been the spot of the Hanukkah celebration with the lighting of the monarch since 2003. There are 5 jetties located at the gateway, of which 2 are used for the commercial ferry operation. Okay children, the gateway was the site of the terror attack in 2003. Kyun famous bahut zyada hua, kyunki isme terror attack hua tha 2003 ke in the samne. There was a bomb blast in the taxi parked in front of it. Okay, ek taxi yahan pe park ki gayi thi, usme bomb blast hua tha. Across the gateway was restricted after people congregated at its the premises following the 2008 Mumbai terror attack, in which the Taj Hotel opposite the gateway and other location in is the Win City were targeted. In March 2019, the Maharashtra state government proposed a 4-step plan to develop the location for the convenience of tourists following a direction issued by the state government in 2019, because this area was prohibited for the foreigners, because यहाँ पे जब बम ब्लास्ट हुआ तो सचमुच ये बहुत सेंसिटिव एरिया हो गया था, और गेटवे यहाँ से बहुत पास में एकदम सामने है गेटवे ताज होटल, और आपको पता ही होगा कि कैसे टेररिस्ट अटैक हुआ, उसमें बहुत सारे हमारे पुलिस ऑफिसर की डेथ हो गई, उनको भी उसमें मारा गया. तो दैट वाज रियली अ टेरिफाइड कांड. And as you all know, it was built in the commemorate the arrival of George V, Emperor of India, and Mary of Tech. Okay, so this is the jewel of crown. Actually, Jawaharlal Nehru refers to the gateway as a jewel in the crown and a symbol of the conquest and colonization. The monument commemorates the legacy of British colonial rule. Okay, so namely the first visit of the British monarch to visit, as it's used at the entry point for the prominent colonial personnel into British India. Okay children, so today the gateway is the synonymous with the city of Mumbai. Since its construction, the gateway has remained amongst the first structural visible to visitors arriving in Bombay by the sea. So it is really a symbol of Mumbai now. And whenever the visitors are coming to the Mumbai, they always visit this place because this is beautifully architected. Now, since 2003, the gateway has been the location for the local Jewish community to light the monarch for Hanukkah celebration every year. So, this ritual was started by the Rabbi Gabriel Noka Hatunberg of the Chabad in Mumbai. Okay, so located in the Nariman House. It has also become a site of prayer following the 2008 Mumbai terror attacks, which targeted amongst the Nariman House. So Rabbi Holzberg lost his life in 2008 terror attack. So this is, you can say this was targeted because of the Jewish people. Now the gateway arch has height of 26 meter, as I already told you, and the monument is built of yellow basalt and reinforced concrete. The stone were sourced locally, while the perforated screens were brought in from Gwalior. So the monument faces towards the Mumbai harbor. There are four turrets on the structure of the gateway, and there are steps constructed behind the arch of the gateway, which lead to the Arabian Sea. So the monument features intricate stone lattice work, also known the Jali work. The Scottish architect George Whitted combined element of the Roman triumphal arch and 16th century architecture of Gujarat. The architecture also combines indigenous architectural elements with element of Islamic architecture known as the Indo-Saracenic. The harbor front were re-lined in order to make an esplanade, which would sweep down to the center of the town. On each side of the arch, there are large halls and the capacity to hold 600 people. The cost of the construction was ₹21 lakhs, ₹2,100,000. Borne by the government due to punctuity of the fund, the approach road was never built. Hence, the gateway stand at the angle to the road leading up to. Okay, children, so this is the Gateway of India. We have already seen the history of the Gateway India. Now we are moving to our next this beautiful monument. And here you can see every year our Prime Minister hoisting the flag, and this is none other than, but this is called Red Fort. Why it is called Red Fort? Because it is made by the red tiles or red stones. So that is why this is called Red Fort. Lal Kila isko bolte hain Hindi mein, aur bahut hi sundar tarike se ye Lal Kila bana hua hai. The Red Fort is the historic front city of Delhi. Ye bhi Delhi mein located hai, but in old Delhi, it's not in New Delhi. In India, that served as the main residence of the Mughal emperors. Emperor Shah Jahan commissioned construction of the Red Fort on 12th May 1638. 1638 mein unhone banaya tha. When he decided to shift his capital from Agra to Delhi. Agra se Delhi jab wo shift hue the, तब उन्होंने ये वाला जो महल था और फोर्ट था वो बनवाया था. ओरिजिनली रेड एंड वाइट, इस डिज़ाइन इज क्रेडिटेड टू आर्किटेक्ट उस्ताद अहमद लाहौरी, हु आल्सो कंस्ट्रक्टेड द ताजमहल. द फोर्ट रिप्रेजेंट द पीक इन मुगल आर्किटेक्चर अंडर शाह जहां एंड कंबाइंस पर्सिनेट पैलेस आर्किटेक्चर विद इंडियन ट्रेडिशन. The fort was plundered for its artwork and jewels during Nadir Shah invasion of Mughal Empire in 1739. Most of the fort marble structures were subsequently demolished by the British following the Indian Rebellion of 1837. The fort defensive walls were largely undamaged, and the fortress was subsequently used as the garrison. On 15 August 1947, the first Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru, raised the Indian flag above the Lahore Gate. Every year on India's Independence Day, 15th August, the Prime Minister hoists the Indian tricolor flag at the Fort Main Gate and delivers a nationally broadcast speech for its ramparts. The Red Fort was designated a UNESCO World Heritage. The Red Fort was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 2007 as part of the Red Fort complex. So children, this is the world known, you can say, building, and we are proud to be here as an Indian because these type of the monuments increase our grace and glory. Now children, I would like to tell you that the name Red Fort is a translation of Hindustani Lal Kila. Lal Kila, Urdu, okay, it is in the language of Urdu, deriving from its red sandstone walls. Okay children, so Lal was derived from the Hindustani language meaning red, and Kila derived from the Persian words meaning fortress. As a resident of the imperial family, the fort was originally known as the Blessed Fort, Qila-e-Mubarak. Okay, Agra Fort is also known as Lal Kila. So you can say the history, I have already told you that the history, it is made by the Shah Jahan, because he wanted to came back to or shifted his emperorship, or you can say the capital, from Agra to New Delhi. The administrative and physical structure of the Mughal dynasty declined after Aurangzeb, and the 18th century saw a degeneration of the palace. In 1712, Jahandar Shah became the Mughal emperor. Within a year of beginning his rule, Shah was murdered and replaced by Farukhshiyar Muhammad Shah, known as the Rangila, the colorful honor of his interest in art. So after that, in 1939, Persian Emperor Nadir Shah easily defeated the strong Mughal army of these soldiers and plundering the Red Fort, including the Peacock Throne. Nadir Shah returned to Persia after 3 months, leaving a destroyed city and weakened Mughal Huda Muhammad Shah. The internal weakness of the Mughal Empire made the Mughals only titular rulers of Delhi, and a 1752 treaty made the Marathas protector of the throne of Delhi. The 1758 Maratha victory at the Sarhind, aided by the six and successive defeat at Panipat, placed them in the further conflict with Ahmad Shah Durrani. Now children, if you can see, the last Mughal was Bahadur Shah Zafar, and that time ye jo qila tha wo unke liye ek jail ban gaya tha, क्योंकि उनके अपने ही बेटे ने उसको यहाँ पे जेल कर दिया था. तो बहादुर शाह जफर वॉज अ लास्ट मुगल हु फॉट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर्स, एंड दिस इज दैट इज़ वाई द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ दिस फोर्ट बिकेम मच लार्जर इन आर इंडियन हिस्ट्री, बिकॉज मुगल बहादुर शाह जफर फॉट अगेंस्ट द ब्रिटिशर्स, और उन्होंने ब्रिटिशर्स के ही खिलाफ़ नहीं बल्कि अपने खुद के बेटा जो कि उनसे मिल चुका था उसके खिलाफ़ भी बहुत स्ट्रगल किया. सो चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ द फोर्ट इज़ नॉट ओनली नोन फॉर द एम्परर्स, बट इट इज़ नोन ऑल्सो फॉर द पैट्रियटिज्म. दोज हु आर पैट्रियाटिक, दे कैन अंडरस्टैंड the value of this fort. That is why our prime ministers used to host the flag over here. So this is the beautiful place. Whenever you are coming to the Delhi, please visit this place. This is our national monument. Now children, we are going to see our next beautiful monument that you can't imagine how beautiful it is, because it is made with white marble, beautiful marble, beautifully architected by architecture, and it is built by Shah Jahan, beautifully made in the memorial of his wife, beloved wife Mumtaz Mahal. तो अपनी वाइफ की याद में उन्होंने ये सुंदर सा फोर्ट बनवाया था, सुंदर सा मकबरा इसको बोलना चाहिए, एक्चुअली ये मकबरा है. और ये वन ऑफ द वंडर इन द वर्ल्ड, ताजमहल. सो इट इज़ सिचुएटेड इन आगरा इन उत्तर प्रदेश, एंड दिस इज़ द प्राइड ऑफ इंडिया टू बी हियर. सो द ताजमहल, इट्स अ क्राउन ऑफ पैलेस, is an ivory white marble mausoleum on the southern bank of river Yamuna in the Indian city of Agra. It was commissioned in 1632 by the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan, reigned from 1628 to 1658, to house the tomb of his favorite wife Mumtaz Mahal. It also houses the tomb of Shah Jahan himself. यहाँ पर मुमताज महल और शाह जहाँ दोनों की टूम्ब है. The tomb is the centerpiece of the 17 hectare, which include a mosque and a guest house, and is set in the formal gardens bounded on three sides of the serenelated wall. Construction of the mausoleum was essentially completed in 1643, but work continued on other phases of the project for another 10 years. The Taj Mahal complex is believed to have completed in its entirely in 1653, at the cost estimated the time of around 32 million rupees, which is 2020 would be approximately 70 billion rupees. So the Taj Mahal was designed as a UNESCO World designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1983 for being the jewel of the Muslim art in India and one of the universally admired masterpiece of the world heritage. It is regarded by many as the best example of the Mughal architecture and a symbol of India's rich history. The Taj Mahal attracts 7 to 8 million visitors a year, and in 2007 it was declared a winner of the new 7 wonders of the world 2000 to 2007 initiative. So children, this is one, you can say, known as a 7 wonder. Taj Mahal was commissioned by Shah Jahan, as you all know, in 1631. Children, this is not new for you, that it is built to the memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal, who died in 17 June that year while giving birth to their 14th child Ghaura Begum. Construction started in 1632 and the mausoleum. Now children, a tomb is the central focus of entire complex of Taj Mahal. Tomb ekdam center mein hai. और ये सबसे बड़ा कहना चाहिए फोकस जो किया गया है वो टूम पे किया गया है. इट इज़ अ लार्ज वाइट मार्बल स्ट्रक्चर स्टैंडिंग ऑन ए स्क्वायर प्रिंथ एंड कंसिस्ट ऑफ द सिमेट्रिकल बिल्डिंग विथ एन इवॉन एंड आर्च शेप्ड डोरवे टॉप्ड बाय द लार्ज डोम एंड फिनाइल. लाइक मोस्ट मुगल टूम्स, द बेसिक एलिमेंट्स आर इंडो इस्लामिक इन ओरिजिन. The base structure is a large multi-chambered cube with the chamfered corners forming an unequal eight-sided structure that is approximately 55 meters, 100 feet on each of the four long sides. Each side of the Iwan is framed with a huge pistache or vaulted archway with two similarly shaped arch balconies stacked on either side. This motif of the stacked pishtacks is replicated on the chamfered corners areas, making the design completely symmetrical on all sides of building. Four minarets frame the tomb, and at one at each corner of the plinth facing the chamfered corners. The main chamber houses the false sarcophagi of the Mumtaz Mahal and Shah Jahan. The actual graves are at the lower level. So children, here you can see is this beautiful monuments. And now we will discuss about this. This is Char Minar. So here you can see why it is called Char Minar, because it's having Char Minars, and it is located in Hyderabad, Telangana district. Okay. So children, we are going to discuss about this. Okay, children. So children, this is Char Minar, and constructed in 1591, children. And it is monuments and mosque located in Hyderabad, Telangana. India, the landmark has become known globally as a symbol of Hyderabad and is listed among the most recognized structure in India. It has also been officially incorporated as an emblem of Telangana for the state of Telangana. The Char Minar's long history includes the existence of a mosque on its top floor for more than 400 years. While both historically and religiously significant, it is also known for its popular and busy local markets surrounding the structure and has become one of the most frequent tourist attraction in Hyderabad. Char Minar is also a site of numerous festival celebration such as Eid-ul-Adha and Eid-ul-Fitr. The Char Minar is situated on the east bank of the Musi River. To the west lies in the Lad Bazaar, and to the southwest lies the richly ornamented granite Makkah Masjid. It is listed as an archaeological and architectural structure on an official list of the monuments prepared by the Archaeological Survey of India. The English name is translation and combination of Urdu words char and minar, or minar translating to four pillars. The eponymous towers are ornate minarets attached and supported by the four grand arches. So children, this is situated in Hyderabad, children. This is beautiful structure of Hyderabad, and this is called Char Minar. So children, here we have already done these all four structures. Okay children, so we are going to learn these structure. We have seen children, this is Lotus Temple, and this is Gateway of India, and this is you can see Lal Qila, Taj Mahal, and Char Minar. So children, we will meet again in our next video. We will solve the exercise and we will do more exercises on the basis of this chapter. So children, till then, bye bye and take care.